Hey guys, it's Kevin again with my review for the season premiere of Orphan Black Season 3, Episode 1, The Weight of This Combination, and I could not wait for this premiere. I mean, last year's finale, I thought was amazing. I love the way that they ended it, and I really didn't know what was going to happen this season. I mean, the cliffhanger was awesome, you know, that we knew we were introducing male clones, and I was really interested in seeing how they're going to incorporate that into the story, and I'm going to say right now, this is probably going to be the best season of Orphan Black. I'm just calling it now. I mean, it's so much more interesting this season. There's so much more at risk here, and I loved it. And this was an amazing premiere. I absolutely love this episode, and I can't wait for the rest of the season. And honestly, this premiere made me realize how much I missed this show. Am I going to watch it over Outlander? No. No way I'm going to do that, because Outlander is, you know, a completely different show from Orphan Black. It's better than Orphan Black. But I still love Orphan Black. I know I missed it. And I was very happy to see it come back. So let's just get into this episode because it was amazing. And right in the beginning, it kind of is really sad because we see Helena in the beginning of the episode, and she's dreamed about the perfect life with her sisters. You know, everything's just perfect. She's in Allison's backyard, and she's pregnant. They're holding a baby shower for her. Everything just looks adorable and looks perfect. It kind of reminds me of that dancing scene in the finale. But the problem is, that's not her life. It's just, it's not that simple. And it's really sad because, you know, Kira's okay. They don't have to worry about anything until the dream ends, and we see where Helena really is. And I thought overall it was just a really good way to start because it reminds us, oh yeah, Helena was kidnapped at the end of the last season. And, you know, we know that she was kidnapped by Project Castor. We know what they were going to do with her. And we see right away that she's now in this crate with its scorpion trapped with her. And she's hearing things. And the scorpion is actually talking to her. It's really weird, but it honestly was kind of funny the way the scorpion was talking to her. And the reason scorpion talks to her is because the scorpion is actually the bug of the human mind. Like, it can make you think things. So I thought that was really interesting when we saw that with Helena. And plus, Helena has no one to talk to. So obviously, she's going to start to, you know, vision that this scorpion is talking to her. And it's really crazy, but Helena is just as crazy. And I love seeing that we saw that scene with Helena. I thought that was really well done. And I really love that. So I thought that was really great. So we then see Sarah Felix, and so then we see back at Project Dyad, basically, that everyone is trying to fix Sarah. You know, not Sarah, they're trying to fix Rachel, because of course Rachel was stabbed with that pencil, but we see that Rachel's not dead. They're trying to reconstruct her face, fix her and everything, and she has, like, this tape over her, but she's not in the best condition right now. So I thought that was interesting that she wasn't dead, because I thought when Sarah stabbed her, for sure she was dead, but she's not dead, so I thought that was interesting. So Sarah, Felix, and Kira are back at the beach that first started all, where Sarah's memorial was held in Season 1, which I thought was kind of interesting. And they send Kira off to find Monkeyfish, while Felix and Sarah start discussing what to do next when Delphine pulls up in a brand new car. And basically she takes Sarah to the Dyad, where they're holding one of the boy clones, because they know that there are these boy clones now, because of course Sarah saw them, and now they don't know how really to react to them. And we meet one of them right away, and I love that they didn't take us too long to get to them. We meet one of them right away, and one of the things I love about these male clones is that they are doing exactly what Tatiana Maslany is doing. They have one guy playing all the male clones, and that guy's name, I'm going to look right now to see what that guy's name is. That guy's name, sorry, I wish I would have known what his name was before. I'm looking up his name. Okay, season 3. I don't know what his name is, but they have the same guy playing all of the male clones, which I think is awesome. And I'm very happy that they're doing that. And he is doing a fantastic job in the show. Just from seeing his character, I can already tell that I'm going to love these characters, definitely. And one of the things you know about these male clones, that you don't know if they're working for Sarah or against them, a Project Cast or someone they should be worried about, even if they're bad people or not. You don't really know anything about them, and I really like seeing that. We don't really know if we can trust them or not, because honestly, who knows if we can trust them? I just really like that we weren't sure if we can trust them. So basically, she talks to Rudy, who he knows all about her life already. They think she's a legend, basically. I thought that was really interesting that we saw that. And basically, you know, they caught him when he and his brother were forcing themselves a new clone, Crystal, and luckily they intercepted before Crystal was killed. But when they take him in, he demands that he only speaks to Sarah, and that's because he thinks her is like this legend and everything, and he knows about her life, he knows which clone she's met, how many sisters she has, and everything else in her life, including Kira. And it kind of is a little bit threatening and a little bit weird that he knows all this stuff. So Sarah doesn't really trust him, obviously, because he knows all this stuff and she doesn't trust him. And Sarah threatens him, and Delphine tells the guards to remove her from the room because she doesn't know how she's going to react to all this. And it's then that Rudy tells Sarah to count her sisters, and she calls everyone to make sure they're okay. And that confirms that Project Caster is going to be a huge threat to Project Dyad. And we know that Project Caster is not going to be a good thing and that they should be worried. And I thought that was crazy. And it's a very subtle way to just show that these male clones are going after them. So she calls everyone to make sure they're okay, because she has no idea what's going to happen. It's understandable why. I mean, obviously, she has no idea what Rudy was talking about. She didn't know if he was serious, and that's when she realizes that Helena's already missing, and she goes to meet Felix at Mrs. S's place, but then Delphine reveals that Topsy is actually sending a cleaner to Dyad to make sure everything is going okay, and no one can know what happened to Rachel. So basically, because of what's happened to Rachel, basically Sarah has to pretend to play Rachel. And Sarah's like, hell no, I'm not doing that. I mean, she's already played, you know, think of all the people she's played before. You know, she played Brooke, you know, she played Brooke, she played Cosima, when she's played all of the characters. And she doesn't want to play Rachel. She doesn't want to do this now because it's just, she really does not want to see that happening. You know, she doesn't want to see her play Rachel all the time, and it really annoys her that she has to keep doing that. And it's kind of funny that she always gets resolved into these situations. She just can't catch a break, and I really like seeing that. So naturally she says no. She's like, there's no way she's gonna do this, and you can see why. So Allison's then at her kids' soccer practice when Marcy, the neighbor mom, comes over to convince her to vote for her for school trustee. But if Marcy gets the job, then she's going to change the electoral boundaries and take Allison's neighborhood out of the school district, which would force her kids to change schools. So instead, Allison tells Marcy that she's actually going to run against her, and I think that's actually really interesting. We got a little bit of competition going on, and I'm interested in seeing what's going to happen there. And then we see Donnie, and of course, Donnie, we know they're not really on the best of terms, but I like what they're doing with Donnie this season. He shows up and tells Allison that he just got fired, and and it's kind of funny what he said, that he basically, you know, said something and he got fired. I thought that was really funny. So they have to go over all their finances to see how they're doing to make it through it, to see if they can, you know, can get through all this and see if they're still in good condition, everything, make sure they have enough money for their kids. And I thought that was really interesting that we saw that, and I was interested in how that was going to go. So Mrs. S gets home to find a boy clone has sneaked his way in, and she gets attacked. And this one isn't Rudy, though, because he is much different. This guy's name is Seth, and basically Seth wants to know more information, and this guy's even more intimidating. He has this really creepy mustache, and again, I have to applaud this guy. I mean, because he's playing the villain here, and it's much harder to play the villain than it is to play the hero. I mean, Tatiana Maslany is fantastic as all these clones, but what he has to do is much harder because he has to play the villain here, and I love it. So basically, he wants to know more information about Ethan Duncan and his research, demanding to know where the research is because Mrs. S doesn't know where it is. Seth knocks her out, leaves, and that was such a crazy scene. I thought that was insane, and I love that. Just that was crazy. So basically, then we see that Delphine meets with Rachel's doctor, who tells him that Topside is sending a man named Ferdinand, the cleaner, to make sure everything is okay. So, you know, to make sure that Rachel's okay and everything. And, of course, they can't know that Rachel was stabbed, so they have to cover it up somehow. So the doctor says that there was an incident in Helsinki in 2006, and Delphine tells him that Marion informed her about it, and she's there to make sure it doesn't happen again. The question is, what is it? What is this, thing? We don't find out. But that's when they both agree that they need to prioritize Project Lita over the individuals, whatever that means. So that's basically what they have to do. Because, of course, obviously Project Caster is a threat, and they have to make sure Project Lita is okay. And I like that they're realizing that Project Lita is their main concern here, and I thought that was really good. So Felix and Sarah come to the house to find Mrs. S in a terrible condition, and she tells them, and I like that she told them this, because I was wondering how they were really going to handle Mrs. S. Because, as we know, Mrs. S is the one that was working with Project Caster, and I was wondering, you know, if Mrs. S was going to turn against them, if they should trust her. But we see straight out that she tells them right away that the boy clones who visited her wanted Duncan's research. It's also then that she tells them that Sarah's the one, she reveals Sarah that she's the one who traded Helena for Sarah's safety. And Sarah's pretty pissed off. You know, she's like, why would you do that? That was not your business to do. And she walks out, leaving Felix to care for her. And I honestly felt really bad for Miss S because she didn't mean to do anything bad. She just wanted to save Sarah. And even though it meant sacrificing Helena, you know, she wanted to save Sarah. So she did have good intentions. It was just really sad to see that she did that to Sarah. I really felt bad that happened to Sarah. I mean, I really felt bad for Mrs. S, and I understand Sarah's upset, but at least try to forgive her. I hope that she at least tries to, because she should try to forgive her, because Mrs. S, I mean, didn't really do anything wrong. She just did something bad. She screwed up, and she knows she did, which I like seeing. So Kasim, in the meantime, is feeling way better. She's living with Felix, and she's also living with Kira, and I kind of like the split focus now, because we're so used to seeing Sarah living with Felix, but Felix is actually living with Kasim now, and I like seeing that. So they're talking with Kira, and Kasim answered the door, and Delphine is there, and I was like, okay, this is going to be interesting, because as we know, they were really having a lot of relationship problems, and I was interested in what was going to happen there, and it's the most heartbreaking scene of the episode by far. I thought the scene was very heartbreaking, but it was very well done. Because Delphine tells her she's not looking for her, she's looking for Sarah, and basically she wants to know what's going on, and Delphine tells her that she's taking over Rachel's position, she won't be working with her and Scott for a while, and she also tells Kasim that she's keeping her promise to love all her sisters equally, but to do that she can't be in a relationship with Kasim anymore, and you see Kasim, she's really crushed by it, she wants to do whatever she can to fix it, but it's just too late. Delphine tells her that, you know, Delphine leaves and Kasima tells her she loves her, and I just thought that was really sad overall. Do I think they're going to get back together? Yes, I do think so. But it's really sad now. I mean, I really, you know, because you really do feel bad for Kasima. You like Delphine and Kasima together. I mean, they're really the couple we root for on this show, and I really was upset that Kasima and Delphine had to split. That was really sad. Even though I love Sarah and Cal, I mean, Cal's pretty much gone. I don't know if Cal's coming back. We'll see, though. So then we see Allison, and Donnie doesn't want to take from the retirement fund and suggests that Allison goes back to work for her mother's store, Bubbles, and they agree that Marcy has to go, you know, for the kids, and I thought that was really interesting. So basically, Allison's going to do whatever she can to take down Marcy and go Allison. I love seeing Allison in this position. I love seeing Allison be, you know, the dominant, independent woman that she is. We always have seen her this way, and it's awesome to see. And just these fun, I love that Allison always gets the really fun plots. That's something I always loved about Allison's character. She adds a lot of humor to the show, and I love that. So Sarah meets Delphine at Rachel's place, and she has agreed to play the part of Rachel Duncan, even though Felix really wasn't sure she should do it. In fact, he was trying to convince her not to do it, but she said she had to do it to save Helena, and I like that she did decide to, because there's no other way to save Helena. The only way to save Helena is to play the part of Rachel, so really she had no, you know, she really had no, and you know, she really could not say no because of that, so I like that she agreed to that. So they make an agreement that as long as Sarah does this, Delphine will help her get Helena back from Project Castor, which is great. So basically, Scott arrives to help Kasima with her checkup, and she tells him about Delphine's new role, and she also shares the book that Duncan wrote his key in, but she tells him she doesn't want to share it with anyone else, not even his, her sisters, until they solve it. So definitely, there's this new book now, and we need to find out what's going on there, and I'm interested in seeing what's going to happen there, what's in this book, if they're going to solve it. I mean, I think it's really interesting. Didn't we have a book to solve last year? Now we have another book to solve, and I think that's really interesting to find out what's actually in this book. We'll see what happens there. So Sarah goes to make an appearance as Rachel in Delphine and Ferdinand's meeting because that was the expectation, but Ferdinand requests she stays for the entirety of it, which kind of ruins their plan. So Sarah tells Ferdinand that Castor has her twin, Helena. He demands to speak with Sarah, and basically he brings Sarah along with him, and basically they go down into the holding area where Sarah, aka Allison, who's playing the role of Sarah, is, and she actually did a good job, because as we've seen before, Allison is not the best at imitating clones, and here she actually did a good job, and I like seeing that Allison is getting better at it. You know, before, if you go back to season one, there's a scene where Allison is pretending to be Sarah. She's terrible at it. She does a terrible job imitating Sarah. But now that Allison, you know, is more used to being around Sarah all the time and things like that, I think she definitely is starting to do a better job of playing the part of Sarah, which I really like seeing. Because I was worried that when Allison, I was like, oh no, is she going to screw this up? This is not a good idea. Basically, Ferdinand puts on gloves for a reason unknown to us, and we don't really know what's going to happen. And then he starts fondling her, and he's expecting scars from Sarah's ovarjectomy, and Allison starts reacting toward the unwanted touching, and Sarah slaps her into silence, which works, and basically, Delphine tells Ferdinand that they need to talk, and they leave the holding room so she can explain they had to postpone Sarah's ovarjectomy, and Ferdinand accepts this as a fact and then tells him to return Sarah to her cell, and meanwhile he tells Rachel they need to discuss Holinsky so he will come to her place that night. So after their visit with fake Rachel, Delphine visits the very real Rachel in her hospital bed, and Rachel is still healing, she's still awake, but she's clearly had some sort of brain damage from the incident, and I like seeing this happen to Rachel, because as I've said before, I don't like Rachel's character. I think Rachel's a bitch. I think she's really annoying. And to see something happen to Rachel, I think it's going to make her character a lot more vulnerable. And I think the thing they're going to do this season is get us to care more for Rachel and show that she actually does have some sort of human side to her. Because all we've seen of Rachel so far is she's been really bitchy. She hasn't been nice to her sisters. She's tried to get away from her sisters. Like, we haven't really seen Rachel do something nice for her sisters. And I like seeing Rachel now in this position of, you know, basically stuck. She's in this position now. She's not healing correctly. And I like seeing this, definitely. She's awake, but she's clearly had some brain damage. And basically, Delphine asks her a few questions like, what's her name? But when Rachel answers too slowly, she forces her thumb on Rachel's missing eye, torturing the answer out of her. She uses this technique, basically. We realize that Rachel's playing dumb. Okay, she's playing dumb. She definitely has some sort of brain damage, but she definitely is playing dumb. So she uses this technique to find out where Ferdinand and Rachel really planned. And apparently Rachel knows about Holinsky, despite the fact that she is not supposed to know about it. So how does she know? Why is Ferdinand lying to, you know, why is Ferdinand lying to Delphine? What does Rachel know about Holinsky, and what even is Holinsky? So Ferdinand is basically wanting sex from Rachel. However, she won't give him what he wants, obviously. This is not going to be like Paul in season one. And she demands to talk about Helena and Holinsky. He says that Holinsky was her decision because if the sisters kept going at it, they could expose Topside. And what exactly is Holinsky? He explains that they terminated 6 clones in Holinsky within 24 hours with only 32 collateral. So as soon as Sarah's ovaries are gone, they will terminate her. And Cosima's plan for tomorrow. So obviously they want to try to destroy these clones. It's not a good thing. And basically they should be really worried now. And I love that they're really worried. I love it. They want to destroy, you know, Project Lita. I'm very worried about what's going to happen there. And it's really insane. So why does Rachel think this is a good thing? I mean, does she not realize they're going to terminate clones and they're going to kill them? I mean, she's in risk of dying here. So why is Rachel okay with this happening? Rachel's a clone too, so they could do this to her. I mean, eventually she's going to be the last one. If this does work, she's going to be the last one left. So Rachel has to do whatever she can to try to stop this, because she needs to realize that this is a bad thing. This isn't a good thing that's happening. This isn't something that she should be happy about, even though she is happy about it. She shouldn't be, because it's not a good thing. So Sarah calls Allison, obviously, to make sure that she's okay. She tells her to get her kids. She goes to the bathroom and she warns Allison to get her kids to get out of the house, and they're coming for her, but she's working out and she doesn't pick up. And my question is Allison going to look at her phone? Is some bag and have Allison? I'm very worried about Allison. After that scene, I got really worried about her. So Ferdinand walks in and gets all flirty with her, saying that he knows that Rachel wants kids and he doesn't recognize who she is right now. So Sarah takes matters into her own hands, taking his belt off of him, and starts to choke him on the bed because he likes it raw like that. And, you know, he does enjoy that kind of, like, BDSM. Honestly, some people compare this to 50 Shades of Grey, and I'd have to say that as well. Definitely is like that. And she starts going way too tight, though, but luckily Delphine interrupts and stops her from killing him. I thought she was going to kill Ferdinand, but that just wouldn't be... That'd be too easy, honestly. If she would have killed Ferdinand, would be upset, because that's actually a very interesting plot with him wanting to, like, eliminate the clones, and I think that's really interesting. So Delphine tells Ferdinand that he was supposed to do a security review of self-aware clones, not screw them, which is true, and that Topside will definitely kill him for this. So she tells him to call off Holinsky just in time for Allison to not get killed by the creepy man who almost chloroformed her in her garage, and that was great that Delphine saved her, basically. Because if Delphine hadn't saved her, this could have ended up really bad if Delphine would not have saved her. So luckily, Delphine did save her, which I was happy about, because I was worried that something was going to happen, and luckily Delphine saved her, which was great. So basically, we then see the end of the episode, which I thought was awesome. I love the way this episode ended. We see that Helena is still picturing that scorpion. The scorpion tells Helena to imagine herself inside a box, inside another box, and then just so happens to be when the woman in charge of Helena's holding cell tells one of the male clones to remove her from it. And basically, she's going to another box. This is only the first one, so she's going to go into another box. And the question is that scorpion going to follow her? And also, what is this male clone all about? Why is he the one that is imprisoning? Why is he the one that's imprisoning Helena? We don't know too much about these male clones, but I don't want to know too much about them. Because the end of the episode, I'm definitely interested in seeing what's going to happen there. Because we then see Rudy, and Rudy's talking to this guy, shoots him in the head, and then we see that he gets shot in the head while he's talking to him. And we see... We then see what Seth go up to Rudy and basically says, hello, brother. So they're going to be working together. And what their plan is, I don't know, but I'm very intrigued to see what their plan actually is. And that's basically how the episode ends. So overall, guys, an amazing season premiere. I love the way the season started, and I really love how intense the season really is. Already, we're in for a very intense season, and I can't wait for it. There's a lot to definitely talk about that I definitely wanted to talk about first. Let's talk about this whole thing with Project Dyad, what they want to do. What's going to happen here? I mean, Project Dyad obviously wants to eliminate all these clones, so how are they going to stop them? We'll see what happens. I mean, that's going to be really interesting. What is Project Caster's actual plan for the clones? Do they want to, you know, what do they exactly want to do them? We don't really know what's going on. All we know is that they want something from them. We just don't really know what it is right now. They keep wanting information on Ethan Duncan, and I don't know really what they want, but we'll see what happens. Is Rachel really have all that brain damage, or was she just kidding? I don't know. If she does, I think it could be really interesting because it could make us care more about her character, which I love to care more about her character because right now I don't really. I mean, I like Rachel's character. I don't hate her by any means, but I don't like her, you know, I don't like her character overall. I think Tatiana Maslany does a great job, but I hate her character. I really do. She's a bitch, and I really want to see what else they can do with her, because I think that could be really interesting if she does have that brain damage. Let's talk about Mrs. S. Is Sarah going to forgive Mrs. S for what she did with Helena? Obviously, Helena needs to be saved. We're going to see what happens. I'm really interested in seeing why specifically that male clone imprisoned Helena. What does he want from her? What exactly is the plan? Is this going to be something where he wants a baby like it was in season 2? I mean, I'm interested in seeing definitely what's going to end up happening. Let's talk about Delphine. Does Delphine know exactly what Ferdinand wants to do? I don't think she does. Obviously, Rachel does. So why does Rachel approve of this? I don't know. I can't wait to see what happens with Allison and Donnie. I always love it. They give Allison the fun plot. Is Allison going to be able to take down Marcy? I hope she does. That'll be a lot of fun to see if Allison can do that. And that'd be a lot of fun as well. Kasim and Delphine, I'm really upset that they did break up, but I'm pretty sure they will get back together. Is this going to hurt Kasima? What's going to happen? I'm very interested in seeing what's going to happen there as well. But overall, guys, I'm already loving this season. I think this is going to be an amazing season. By far, this is already probably this is probably going to be the best season. I definitely see this being a very convoluted season. I mean, everything is so much more intense now than we have these male clones, because we know that they're out for the female clones, and they're not as safe anymore, and it definitely is a lot worse for them. So I'm interested in seeing what's going to happen there. And I definitely feel like we're getting into a mate. I definitely feel like there's going to be a huge death this season. I think they're going to kill off one of the clones. I'm pretty sure they will. I mean, it might just be time. I'm not saying that I want them to, but I just feel like they're going to. I really feel like they're going to kill off one of the clones, but we'll see what happens. But overall, guys, let me know what you guys saw of this premiere. Overall, I thought this was an amazing premiere, and I'll see you guys in my next video, which will be for another Classic Mirror review. So I will see you guys for that. Okay, bye.